those mics pick up so much more.
Oh, yeah. Than
the mic on it, although the
doesn't come a long way.
This is still it's a great one. And we got it. I enjoy Caleb too.
Caleb was back in class today. The track shooting was like right after school, and there was a very small window between these.
Thank you. There's a shocker.
It's awesome.
Thank you again for being here. Just as a preemptive so you know what this music is about. So the music you hear tonight is also the music they will perform at large group contest on Friday. For those who aren't sure what that is, it's a they go and they get rated on how they play their music. They listen to things for like the accuracy of their notes, how musical they're playing it, and how much they're playing together as a group. So like each of the judges has our scores, like the parts that have all of the parts in them, and they rate them on how well they are doing that, how accurately they are doing that, and musically they are doing that. So tonight from the band, you're going to hear two different pieces. The first one is called The Light Eternal, and I promise I'll try to be short on this. This one is based upon some historical vote. On February 3rd, 1943, the SS Dorchester, an American troop transport vessel, sank in the icy waters off the coast of Greenland, the victim of a German U-boat. Of the 904 men aboard, 605 were lost. Among those who perished were four Army chaplains, each of a different faith, each called to the same duty. The testimony of the survivors tells the story best. As overcrowded lifeboats capsized, as rafts drifted away empty and men milled around on deck on the ragged edge of panic, the only fragment of hope came from these four men, and when the life jackets were gone, they gave away their own. As the survivors swam away, they remember the chaplain standing, their arms linked braced against the slanting deck. They were praying, words of prayer in Latin, Hebrew, and English, addressed to the same God. So the parts of this that you will hear is kind of a happier part that's a celebration of life. And then you hear a hymn is based upon God of our fathers. And then you will hear the sinking of the ship, which will be very dramatic. And then other variations upon God of our fathers, the Light Eternal. The second piece they're playing is called Nathan Hale Trilogy. Nathan Hale was an American patriot of the Revolutionary War. He was hanged by the British as an American spy when he was only 21 years old. His conduct and his courage have made him one of America's best-remembered heroes. This triptych, a three-movement work, represents three important places or events in Nathan Hale's life. The first one is the Entrada. In July 1775, he received a lieutenant's commission from the Connecticut Assembly and fought in the Siege of Boston. The second one is the Intermezzo. It's a tribute to Hale site, a monument that marks the place of his capture and death. Before he was hanged, he made a speech concluding with the words which have since inspired Americans, "I only regret that I have but one life to lose for my country." The third movement is called the Rangers, a small fighting group of which he was a member, that they were respected for their fighting qualities and their daring leadership in dangerous missions. So this is a three-movement work. Typically, audiences wait for all three movements before applying. So I know it feels a little awkward like they end something, but just try not to clap in between the three movements.
Thank you. All right, so since this is our last concert of the year here at Bishop Garrigan, we do want to take a moment to recognize our seniors who have been with us for these many, many years. So seniors, whether you're band or choir, we ask that you come forward and walk to the front of the stage.
Cheers, we couldn't say no.
Have a lovely night, everyone.